Nothing beats a good ghost story on Halloween, except maybe a good vampire story. And it's all told from beside the grave of Rhode Island's most famous one, Mercy Brown.
Listen closely. You could hear a message from beyond the grave.
Everybody will be able to hear you, George or Edwin or Mercy.
We're listening for any of the Brown family members.
When I come, I talk about the tragedy, what happened, and I always ask them if they have a message that they want to get out, because I think sometimes they do. So,
do you think maybe we'll get a message today?
I hope so. Fingers crossed, Michaela. We're going to try.
Let's find out.
As Deb and the rest of DLH Paranormal get equipment ready, I'm brushing up on the story from the late 1800s.
Exeter back then was just out in the middle of nowhere. There was nothing around, so people got really frightened.
The Brown family have lost three relatives and what looks like a fourth.
Edwin was actually having nightmares while he was sick that someone was coming and trying to suck the life out of him.
Remember, the year is 1892, and at the time, people assumed that when multiple family members died, it was the work of the undead. So they decided to take action. George, the father, now has to dig up his wife and his daughter, Mary. His other daughter, Mercy, was stored here, which in the wintertime was essentially a freezer, causing her body to look a lot different.
So when they exhumed her body, they found blood in the heart. Her hair had grown, her nails, but because she was frozen. But they didn't understand that back then, and they thought that Mercy was a vampire.
Hear that?
Their idea for a cure was interesting.
They cut out her heart, they burned it, and they mixed the ashes with water, and then Edwin had to drink the ashes.
Ugh.
So I know it's disgusting.
It didn't work, and Edwin passed away.
Back then, a lot of people died from consumption, which was actually tuberculosis.
Poor George Brown, he loses his wife, Mary, his daughter, Mary, his other daughter, Mercy, and eventually his son, Edwin, all from the same misunderstood disease.
I feel like we're here with them.
If you really want to feel close, get the right gear.
They sweep the radio frequencies. We sweep in reverse so that we know it's not the radio, and we go at the fastest sweep rate. You can actually shut the antenna off, so there is no radio interference.
So we'll know that this is the real deal.
That was just a leap.
Spirits are able to go through and pick the words that they'd like to say that are relevant to maybe, you know, what they're trying to get out as a message.
So we'll know the word.
Yep, it'll say right on the screen.
Video.
Yeah,
we are taking video of you.
So you know when a word is relevant.
Not everything is high tech. Sometimes you need the classics, like dowsing rods.
I use them for energy because the energy that we have with ghost hunting, it makes them work as well. The way you have them down like that, that's perfect. And you want to have a pretty good grip, a little loose, and then they would cross.
Every so often, I do feel one kind of going back and forth. Oh, there's a spider over there. I'm not going down any further.
But yeah.
See, the spirits don't affect me, but that spider, that'll keep me away.
Others frequent her grave and leave some pretty odd things.
There's a piece of glass.
Chapstick?
Yeah.
A cigarette?
And there's a piece of glass there that's almost in the shape of a dagger, which is kind of creepy. And then what I think is really cool, on the other side, there's a book where you can sign in.
So, was Mercy Brown really a vampire, or is the whole story just a local legend? We'll leave that up to you.
Creepy. Have you ever visited any haunted spots in our area? Share your stories with us. Reach out anytime on our social media pages, Facebook, Twitter, or even Instagram. They're all at The Rhode Show.